You're watching Unreal Ant Gaming. This is Gohan from Dragon Ball Z. You want to see me turn Super Saiyan? Or should I take it to the next level? I'm also the narrator, too. Next time on Dragon Ball Z, make sure and smash subscribe to Unreal Ant Gaming.
As the final battle involving Murno, Gogeta, and Broly finally commences on planet Vampa, Gogeta and Broly are left with no other choice than to use their full power in having to stop Murno from further destroying the universe, as seen on the previous manga chapter video, with Gogeta momentarily gaining the upper hand in achieving Ultra Instinct. Our heroes are now placed into a situation to where Gogeta can no longer achieve the powers of Ultra Instinct, but given their collective power, is it possible for Super Saiyan Blue Evolution Gogeta and full-powered Super Saiyan 3 Broly to overtake the former angel of the 13th universe Murno, or is Murno really hiding more power than how he's letting off in hiding something up his sleeve? As once more before we begin, if you are new to this channel and have a love and passion for all things Dragon Ball and anime related, then be sure to smash that subscribe button on this channel and turn on all notifications to never miss a single upload, along with giving this video a big thumbs up by slapping that like button down below if you guys love Dragon Ball and anime, as well as checking out the official Dragon Ball fan mangas playlist located down in the description box below, to where on that playlist you guys will be able to find all the latest and best Dragon Ball fan mangas created by the community for the community. So be sure to head on down below, check out the official Dragon Ball fan mangas playlist for all the best and latest videos on Dragon Ball fan mangas. As we kick off the Beyond Dragon Ball Super Universe 13 manga chapter special, with Murno shown not wasting any time, battle damaged, hurt, and tired, as he went along to hold up above him a massive energy attack, he only then went along to tell Broly and Gogeta, "I am going to blow you both to pieces, along with this entire planet once I'm done. Your life ends right here, right now." And the second Murno is shown launching his attack, he only then follows by telling them, "To the grave with you both. Now you die with your pride." And with this attack having to be shown raining down, both Gogeta and Broly fire their most powerful attacks directly at Murno's, as of course we end up seeing a massive energy struggle between the collective powers of Gogeta and Broly versus Murno's. And with both sides having to be shown struggling, Gogeta then went along to shout, "We won't allow you to get away with the things you've done. Our power will never be extinguished. Full power, Broly! Use your full power! Hit him with everything you've got! Do it now!" As Murno went along to shout back, "Your combined powers will not save you from meeting your fate. Your destiny is already sealed, mortals. This story ends with the author's pen in my hand." So Murno is looking to end this once and for all, with Gogeta and Broly doing everything they can to make sure that Murno does not get the better of them, as over out in another dimension, we only then, for the first time, get to actually follow up in seeing what happened to the Grand Priest and Whis. As over out in an unknown dimension, Whis and the Grand Priest are shown talking, as Whis went along to ask, "So the original has been hiding in another dimension this entire time? Then how would we know where to find him, Grand Minister?" As the Grand Priest responds, "It appears each time a clone of his has been destroyed, a small energy surge is released from his body. I have no doubt that he is only using these clones as batteries to increase his own power while in hiding." As Whis went along to then comment, "And this realm we are currently in, it feels similar to the Null Realm from which we held the Tournament of Power. It seems he didn't want to seal us away, but rather keep us away to buy time." As the Grand Priest only tells Whis to step back, he only then comments, "I ask you to stand aside, Whis. This will only take but a moment." As only then the Grand Priest is shown extending his hands, he only then continues, "It is rare for me to invoke such power, but it must be done in order for us to be freed from this empty prison. And as the Grand Priest begins to shine, he only then comments, "This dimension will be no more," as only then we get to observe how something is going on involving the Grand Priest in using his power and telling Whis that it is rare for the Grand Priest to invoke such a power, but it is only then needed for them to be freed from this prison, also insinuating the fact that these clones are simply being used by the original as battery sources for the original to get stronger. And as the Grand Priest then begins to reveal more of his power, he only then comments, "He has forced my hand, and now to make sure we never return here again, I will shatter this entire realm. Such a power has not been used by me in billions of years." And with Whis looking on absolutely surprised, he only then comments, "Shatter the realm? Surely you must know that he had been using this realm then as a means of travel then. What do you intend I do in the meantime?" With the Grand Priest then telling him, "You will wait for me to give you the order. Once I call for you, I will need you to act immediately." And with the Grand Priest shown literally shattering this entire dimension, Whis only then comments, "What power?" Because it would only appear that this realm was used as a means of travel, because every single time Myrna wanted to go along to protect his identity from being revealed, or at least protect his energy from being felt, he used one of these dimensions as a means of travel to not be detected by any of the gods or angels. As we only then make our way back to planet Vampa, Murno is shown holding back Gogeta and Broly's blast as he went along to then comment, "The more you push, the greater the loss will be on your end when it's all over. You've wounded me with your fancy ultra instinct, but that still won't be enough to save you from me." And with Gogeta and Broly still shown having to hold their own, Gogeta went along to respond, "It doesn't matter, we will never surrender to you. No matter how strong you are, we will always find a way to overcome the odds and break through our limits." And with Myrno overhearing this, he went along to laugh at the Saiyans by telling them, "Break through your limits? Ha! You can barely hold on to the ground beneath you, yet you talk about finding a way to destroy me? You Saiyans are more delusional than I thought you were. Go on then, shatter through your limits if you can, because you won't. The life force of your bond is fading. You're barely clinging on to your power, can't you see? It's over." And with Myrno shown having to release more energy, in pushing the blast further into Broly and Gogeta, Gogeta and Broly went along to then release more of their power as Gogeta went along to shout, "Never!" As Broly and Gogeta begin to release more power and pouring in more of their energy into this attack, Myrno then notices this as he went along to comment, "You just don't get it, do you? Fools! Push all you want, release as much power as you wish. None of it will make a difference in our fight. Do they think I'm bluffing? Is this a joke, Worms?" As he then lifts his hand from his stomach, he only then continues, "You can barely hold your own against a clone. Now imagine how badly you'd lose against the original. Fools, you just don't get it." As Myrno then uses his second hand, he only then goes on to cry out, "You never stood a chance." As Myrno then releases more power, Gogeta and Broly are shown struggling as Gogeta went along to comment, "Whoa, no, no, this is bad. We're losing ground. Hold on, Broly. We have to keep pushing." As Broly goes on to reply, I can't hold it. It's too strong." And as Myrno overhears this, he only then goes on to laugh and commenting, "Did you really think you were stronger than me? Did you already forget that I had lowered my power to match yours this entire time? The only reason why I haven't killed you sooner was because I was having too much fun. Here's a small taste. Can you feel it? You should have accepted my offer, Broly, but now you will die along with the girl." And as Broly overhears this, he quickly thinks of Shile, as of course we then observe how Myrno absolutely loses his mind in pouring out as much power as he could into this blast, as Myrno then went along to cry out, "Now disappear!" As we then observe how this blast is beginning to not only overtake Gogeta and Broly's attack, but it nullifies it completely, as of course Gogeta and Broly are now faced with a situation that they can't really get themselves out of, as only then Murno's attack completely overtakes both Saiyans, as of course we then witness how the blast itself is so powerful that it's literally sent hurtling out into deep space, as only then, right then and there, do we witness how Murno finally killed Gogeta and Broly. And with Murno shown breathing signs of relief and thus having to put his hands down, he only then went along to comment, "How annoying. Ashes to ashes, dust to dust. I told them it was useless. Such wasted talent. And here they had the chance to live like kings and achieve powers far beyond their understanding." And with Murno creeping closer towards the crater, he only then comments, "Yes, there's no sign of their life force in this realm." Was I lying when I said I was hiding my true power this entire time? Where's your Saiyan pride now, mortals? I am an angel. I am far beyond your Saiyan species. And now that you pests are out of the way, it's time to erase what's left of this universe before reaching the Omni Kings. So it actually turns out that this entire time, Murno wasn't in fact bluffing, but he did have the power to destroy Gogeta and Broly, and that's exactly what he did, because through confirming this by his own accord, Murno can no longer feel the life force energy of Gogeta and Broly. So given the fact that now they're out of the way, there's nobody left to stand in front of Murno's path of destruction, which Murno now is looking to end everything within Universe 7 before making his way to the Omni Kings. But before he does that, we only then go back to the Grand Priest and Whis. As the Grand Priest turns around, he only then tells Whis, "The time is now, Whis. He is at his most vulnerable. Reverse the flow of time to your highest of abilities." And with Whis overhearing this, he only then sticks out his scepter in replying, "Yes, of course. Here we go." And with Murno laughing on Planet Vampa, he only then went along to shout, "You couldn't even hold on to your Ultra Instinct long enough to finish me off. So many missed opportunities." And now to finish, but then out of nowhere, Murno's body suddenly freezes. And with everything around him then beginning to change, Murno then only goes on to question, "What? What's going on? My body? What's happening? I can't." And through a first person perspective, we only then go from Murno having to oversee a massive crater on the planet to Murno now being back in the same position he was just in and being shown holding off against both Gogeta and Broly's attacks. Murno then, as he's left wondering what the heck is going on, went along to comment, "What? How am I here again? This isn't possible. Was time reversed? This shouldn't be possible." With Gogeta and Broly shown struggling, Gogeta only then went along to comment, "Broly, we have to hit him with everything we've got. Don't hold anything back." And with both of them shown pouring more power in their attack, Murno is then shown having to be pushed back, as of course he is the one now beginning to lose ground, as Murno went along to respond, "Curse those insects. They blindsided me. Don't get ahead of yourself. This just gives me the chance to kill you worms twice instead." And now to, but then out of nowhere, right before having to finish his sentence, Murno then begins to cough up blood. And he seems to be really baffled as to what the heck is going on, because all of a sudden, something seems to be changing within Murno that's causing a drastic shift in this battle. As he is then shown shaking, he only then went along to ask, "What's happening to me? Wait, it's that wound. When the fusion reached Ultra Instinct, his attack has caused more damage to my body than I thought. No, I will not lose. This wound will heal, but you won't get a second chance at redemption." With Murno having to be shown placing his hand over his ribs, he is visibly hurt, as Broly is shown having to pour even more power into his attack to push Murno back. It is only there that all of a sudden, Gogeta begins to feel something unusual within his body, as he only comments, "Oh no, it can't be. Not now." As Goku and Vegeta then separated, having to cry out, "No!" They're both shown falling behind Broly, as Goku and Vegeta went along to comment, "Vegeta, this is bad. I can't get up. I don't have any power left. This is bad. Broly's alone out there. We have to do something." With Vegeta responding, "Me too. We used everything we have during our fight. There's not much we can do. If we don't stop him right here, then it's all over, as only then the manga chapter special then comes to a close. Now, this is it. This is essentially it for both parties involving Goku, Vegeta, Broly, and Murno, and given the fact that the Grand Priest and Whis have intervened in not only having to reverse time, but they're also up to something in having some sort of an effect on this battle, but the question lingers, is Murno going to finish them off once again before finally getting to the Omni Kings, or is there going to be a sudden shift in this battle that is somehow going to favor our heroes in this battle against Murno, as of course we are currently working on the finale to this manga chapter special. So again, if of course you guys are new to the channel, then I do encourage you guys to smash that subscribe button, especially if you guys love Dragon Ball and anime, but also we are going to have another massive like goal for this video. If we can smash out 5,000 likes on this video, then I will try to get the video out as fast as I can, because with my artist having to live overseas, there were some complications, especially involving the current status of the world and quarantine, so things were a little behind, but now we're beginning to pick the pace back up, and I'm telling you all right now, the way this is all going to end, it's really going to end in a very unexpected way, because with the original Murno having to be confirmed siphoning power and siphoning energy off the clones, who are also collecting data and collecting energy on their own accord, there is so much more left to the overall narrative that this is going to actually transcend into another series after this is said and done. But the question lingers, how is this specific battle involving this specific clone going to go down? So again, I do thank you all so much for your time. Thank you all so much for watching. I do appreciate your support. Having to commission my artist for this is definitely hefty, so all of your support does mean a lot to me, as it all does go towards providing and contributing towards these fan mangas. So again, I thank you all so much for your patience. I thank you all so much for your support. I also want to know down the comment section below as to what you guys want to see for future series ideas such as this, because if we are going to be entering the era of revealing who the true Murno is, then what is it that you guys want to see specifically from that narrative once we get into it? I want to get your thoughts in the comment section below. Again, thank you all so much for watching. Tune back in for the next video, and I'll be seeing each and every single one of you guys down the comment section below. Have a great day, everybody. Peace. And a quick little reminder before you guys go, if you guys are unaware, I do have a second gaming channel located down in the description box below, so be sure to head on over to Unreal Royale and hit that subscribe button along with turning on all notifications, as to there, you guys will find all different kinds of gaming content that you will not get to find on Unreal and Gaming, titles and video games such as Grand Theft Auto, Call of Duty, Gears of War, Dragon Ball Z Dokkan Battle, Dragon Ball Z Legends, Dragon Ball Z Budokai Tenkaichi IG3, Minecraft, Blair Witch, and many other retro games on that channel. So if you guys are into gaming, then make sure you guys subscribe over on Unreal Royale. I want to thank you all so much for your time, and I'll catch you all in the next one.
This is the Galactic Emperor of the Universe, and of course I'm here to tell you to subscribe to Unrelent Gaming.
Also follow Unrelent Gaming on these social media platforms to stay connected at all times. And if you don't, then very soon you will all be dead! Oh, did someone say Unrelent Gaming? Oh my god.
The fuck's up, Bon? Put on some clothes!
Well, why don't you put on any clothes?
What? I don't need clothes, but Jesus Christ, that's huge! What, Broly?
Frieza.
Uh-oh.
Prepare to die!
Boo, I'm Unreal Gaming! But once you get video, I'll lots of likes, or Boo will turn you into chocolate!
Fados, get over here! Tell these mortals that I'm the biggest Unreal Ant Gaming fan. This is my moment. I'm a part of his notification squad. Universe 7 can have all the fun. I just want the food.
And don't forget to leave a comment on this video. Show some love for the best community on YouTube.
Kakarot!